In this illustration, we intend to simulate the stress within the single layer soil and multi-layer soil in the Abaqus software. You can observe the single layer soil in the right picture, and the multi-layer soil can be seen in the left picture. In these two diagrams, the single layer and multi-layer soil have been compared together. Actually, we have already simulated the multi-layer soil in the Abaqus software, and you can observe that here in YouTube channel as well. And now we intend to simulate the single layer soil in the Abaqus software and compare that with the multi-layer one. In fact, we intend to simulate example 3.7 from Sam Helvani book in the Abaqus software. And here the diagram of vertical stress has been drawn for different depth. I will enter the Abaqus software for simulation. Here first I'll open the previous model that pertains to stress within the multi-layer soil. Here some modifications should be made on the model. But before that, you should first observe this training video and follow the rest of our training subsequently. Actually, you should first observe the training video showing the stress within the multi-layer soil caused by a circular loading. Having observed this training, you can then proceed to watch continuance of the other sections of the film. Here I will enter property module, click on create material. Here I intend to define the properties of soil. As described in Sam Helvani book, the soil has been considered to be in linear elasticity. Young modulus is equal to 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 7 kilopascal, and the Poisson ratio is equal to 0.3. I will select elasticity and elastic from mechanical menu, enter Young modulus equal to 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 10 pascal, and the Poisson ratio equal to 0.3, and click on OK. In the next step, I will click on create section, select solid and homogeneous, and continue. Here I will select the soil material and OK. Then I'll click on Section Assignment Manager. Here I will deactivate all the sections which had already been created. Now I will click on Create, select the whole of soil, done. Here I will select Soil and OK in this manner. Here we don't need to make any particular modification, and the rest of arrangements are similar to that in the previous example. Here I will enter job module, click on create job. Continue, OK, and click on Submit. Here I'll click on Result. Here we intend to draw this diagram in the Abaqus software. Actually, we intend to draw the diagram of vertical stress for different depth. Here, first I'll select Path and Create from the Tools menu, then Continue and Add Before. First, I will select this node, then this one, done, and OK. I will click on Create XY Data, select Path, and Continue. Here, I will select Undeformed, tick on Include Intersection option. Here I'll select S22 or the same vertical stress and OK. Then select Save As and OK. I'll right click on the diagram, Edit. Select these two columns, copy, and paste them in the Excel software. The first column is depth, the unit of which is meter. The second column is vertical stress, the unit of which is Pascal. As you observe in this diagram, the unit of stress is kilopascal, so we should divide all the numbers of this column by 1000, and so the unit of stress will be converted from Pascal to kilopascal. I will click on Insert, select this diagram, then choose the Select Data, click on Add, select this column as the X-axis and this one as the Y-axis, OK and OK. Then I'll double click on X-axis, tick on Maximum Axis Value option, also tick on Value in Reverse Order option. I will do the same for the Y-axis in this manner. The diagram having been drawn in blue is the one obtained from the Abaqus software. As you observe the results having been gained from the Abaqus software are quite concordant with those obtained from some Helwani book. Actually, both the diagrams have been set on each other concordantly. Here we intend to compare the stress within the multi-layer soil with stress within the single-layer soil. In fact, we are going to have a comparing between these two diagrams. We had already calculated the stress within the multi-layer soil and drawn the related diagram, which you can observe that here. And it has been distinguished in this Excel file as well. To do so, I'll first copy these two columns and paste them here. Then I'll choose the Select Data option here, click on Add. Select this column as the x-axis and this column as the y-axis. OK and OK. The diagram having been drawn in brown color is the one obtained from the Abaqus software. The blue diagram is related to the stress within the multilayer soil, and the brown diagram is related to the stress within the single layer soil. As you observe the results having been gained from the Abaqus software are quite concordant with those obtained from some Helwani book. Here we can compare the multi-layer soil with single layer one. By comparing these two diagrams, the effect of asphalt layer and the base layer will be observed clearly. Actually, the asphalt layer and the base layer absorb the damaging stress, and only a small fraction of this stress will be transferred to the sub-base layer and the softer soil layer. Actually, the asphalt layer will act as a shield protecting the softer layers against the stress due to repeated traffic loads.